Hello dear students, in the last video we have seen what is subject verb agreement and its some rules. Now in this video we are going to see some another rules of subject verb agreements. So now let's see. If we omit the words a pair of and merely use the plural word, then it must take a plural verb. For example, your trousers are very costly. Names that refer to a class of things such as stationery, cutlery and hair are singular and must therefore take a singular verb. For example, this furniture is made of wood. Now here we consider furniture here as class of things, and that's why we consider it as a singular noun, and then only we took a singular verb for it. There are some words which treated as singular, for example, news, business, advice, information. For example, this information is very useful for our students. There are certain names of diseases and sciences which ends in s, but they consider as singular. For example, measles, mumps, mathematics, physics, economics, civics. For example, mathematics is a scoring subject. When we used some of and half of with countable nouns, then it take a plural verb. And when we use some of and half of with uncountable nouns, then it takes a singular verb. For example, some of the girls are absent. Now here in this sentence, girls are countable, so we took a plural verb. And in the next sentence, half of the tea in the kettle is finished. Now here in this sentence, tea is uncountable noun. That's why we just consider it and took is as a singular verb for it. When we used fractions, the verb will depend upon the number of the noun which the fractions talk about. For example, 3/4 of the earth's surface is water. Now here in this sentence, we can't count earth's surface in number. That's why we took singular verb. And in the next sentence, 3/4 of the students are present. Now here we can count in number students 1, 2, 3, 4, this. That's why we took a plural verb. Many refers to number, and that's why plural. And much refers to amount or quantity, and that's why singular. For example, many teachers have registered for the training. And in the next sentence, not much is known about the gypsies. In simple words, many is used for countable nouns and much is used for uncountable nouns. When a plural number applies to distances, weights, heights or amounts of money and answers the question how much, then it is treated as singular. For example, 100 miles is a long distance. Words such as people, poultry, police, studies and cattle are used with plural verbs. For example, the people of our area are very quarrelsome. So, it is not necessary that only when we add s or es to the noun, then only it becomes plural. So, such above examples are the exceptions. So, without adding s or es, they are plural. If the title of a book or the name of a house or a hotel is in the plural, it takes a singular verb because it is only one title or one building. For example, Gulliver's Travels was written by Jonathan Swift. When two subjects are joined by the conjunction or, the verb agrees in number and person with the subject that is closer to it. The same rule applies in case of the paired conjunction, for example, either or and neither nor. Now we will see with examples. Mrs. Verma or her sons are going to London. Now here in this sentence, her sons are closer to the conjunction or, and her sons is a plural form. That's why we took are as a verb. Either my cousins or my sister is preparing dinner for us. Now here in this sentence, which is closer subject to the conjunction or, that is my sister, and my sister is a singular noun. That's why we took is as a singular verb. Neither Shital nor I am participating in quiz competition. Now here, which is closer subject to the conjunction nor, that is I, and I is a singular pronoun here. That's why we will just use am as a singular verb. Distributive pronouns such as each, either, and neither are always followed by a singular verb. And indefinite pronouns such as anybody, something, few, and many can take both singular and plural verbs. In this way, dear students, we saw subject-verb agreement. Hope so all of you understood it well. Thank you.